Mr. President, Mr. Secretary General, honorable ministers, excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, at the outset, I would like to thank and congratulate the South African presidency for convening this debate on the United Nations African Union partnership. We welcome the presence at this very important meeting of His Excellency Mr. Jacob Zuma, President of the Republic of South Africa. We are grateful for the report of the Secretary General, Mr. Ban Ki-moon, and I would also like to welcome the delegation of African Union Commission and chairs of the African sub-regional organizations. Over the last decade, the role of the African Union and sub-regional organizations has increased significantly. Indeed, not all regional organizations may boast of their ability and political will to understand the root causes of armed conflicts and to contribute effectively to their resolution. As a country suffering from the occupation of a significant part of its territory and the forcible displacement of hundreds of thousands of its citizens, Azerbaijan fully realizes the threats and challenges affecting the country with unresolved conflicts, including those in Africa, as it was indicated just a few minutes ago by Mr. Wamamra, Commissioner for Peace and Security of the African Union. The African Union has made great efforts with regard to promote peace, security, and stability on the continent, and demonstrated its ability to take the lead. The launch of the African peace and security architecture and the establishment of its constitutive elements, as well as the African Union's peace support operations authorized by the Security Council, should be particularly noted. The challenges that Africa faces today and that constitute a considerable part of the Security Council's deliberations can be better addressed through collective political and diplomatic efforts. High interest in today's debate demonstrates the vivid commitment of the international community to support African countries in bringing stability and ensuring sustainable development on the continent. Over the recent years, we have seen progress that has been achieved in developing the strategic relationship between the United Nations and the African Union in the area of peace and security. At the same time, we have to admit that challenges still remain, and more should be done to further strengthen this relationship to effectively address common collective security concerns in Africa. It is critical and crucial that we further strengthen our joint efforts to prevent conflicts before they occur. Greater focus in the area of conflict prevention and mediation acquires additional significance. Development of common guidelines by the United Nations and the African Union as a framework for mediation in Africa would contribute to achieving this objective. It is crucial that all member states strictly adhere to their obligations as laid down in the United Nations Charter with respect to the sovereignty, territorial integrity, and political independence of states. Important determination in this regard has also been made by the General Assembly in its resolution of June 22nd of 2011 on strengthening the role of mediation in the peaceful settlement of disputes and conflict prevention and resolution, as it was indicated in the document A/Resolution/65/283. We recognize the vital role of women in the prevention and resolution of conflicts, peace negotiations, peace building, peacekeeping, humanitarian response, and post-conflict reconstruction. The United Nations and the African Union need to work to ensure that women and gender perspectives are fully integrated in all peace and security efforts undertaken by the two organizations, including by building the necessary capacity. It is important that the United Nations Security Council and the Peace and Security Council of the African Union, as well as the secretariats of both organizations, further enhance their relationship, including through annual meetings and more intensified informal communications between them. As the Secretary General pointed out in his report, efforts to find a solution to ensure sustainable financing for African Union peace support operations need to be continued. While the steps taken by the African Union in developing its own financing mechanisms are commendable, other means and options provided by the United Nations and international community should also be available in this regard, including in the areas of prevention, management, and resolution of conflict, as well as in peace building. Mr. President, over the recent period, Azerbaijan has significantly developed its cooperation with the African Union and its member states. The status of observer with the African Union allowed my country to advance mutually beneficial relations and dialogue. Azerbaijan is actively participating in implementing various assistance programs for Africa. We responded to the appeals of the respective governments and international organizations to provide urgent aid aimed at addressing the humanitarian crisis in the Horn of Africa and other African countries. Furthermore, we contributed to support the institutions and capacity building program of the African Union Commission and offered scholarships for diplomats from African countries to study in Azerbaijan Diplomatic Academy. Azerbaijan has also joined the work of one of the peacebuilding commissions, country-specific configurations, and look forward to continue its efforts in this regard. We have started consultations with the relevant stakeholders to apply in Africa our rich experience in the field of the mining provided by the Azerbaijan National Agency for Mine Action. We look forward to advancing our cooperation with the AU Commission and African countries, and are planning to host in Azerbaijan, in cooperation with the United Nations and the African Union, a high-level international conference on the issues of Africa's concern. Mr. President, in conclusion, I would like to express our full support to South Africa's draft Security Council resolution aimed at developing effective partnership relations and cooperation between the two organizations. Last but not least, I would also like to take this opportunity and stress the importance for the Council to monitor the implementation of its already adopted resolutions, in particular those related to prevention, management, and resolution of conflicts. Thank you very much, Mr. President.